In this video, we'll learn how to use the ClaroPDF app. This video is current to the app as of March 1st, 2017. The first thing to do is to open your ClaroPDF app. I am using the light version. The paid version, the icon may look slightly different. Okay. To get started, we're going to need to find a PDF that we can annotate or write on. So we go to the folder, and we can choose from one of three places to get our documents. The My Documents tab takes us to our previously stored documents that we've already worked on in Claro. Open From allows us to open it from a different source, and Photo to PDF allows us to use the camera on the iPad to take a picture of a document that we have in our hands. We're going to use Photo to PDF in this demonstration. You'll then have the choice of from the camera or from the library. Typically, our students are taking pictures in the moment, so we would choose from the camera. However, for this demonstration, we're going to go ahead and pick it from the library. This could be used at times when you knew that you were already going to have this document, and so you took a picture in advance. So I'm going to find my worksheet, click on it. Claro will always ask you to save as, to enter a name, and then it will continuously auto-save, so I'm going to call this video. I am using an external keyboard, so you'll notice my keyboard didn't pop up on the screen. I'll hit save. My title comes up at the that I've named my document comes up at the top, and from there I'm ready to annotate on my document. We normally write on our documents with pencil, so we're going to go to the pencil and paper icon, and now a menu has opened up of all the different tools that are available in ClaroPDF. We're going to start working through this worksheet, which will allow us to explore the tools. However, this is a little small for me to write on, so I'm going to use the pinch to zoom. Scroll down. The first question says, my name is. I need to answer that using text. So I'm going to go to the second T, put a text box down, and then I'll type in, my name is Sally Student. Now you'll notice I didn't worry about getting that box exactly perfect on the line. What I'm going to do to move it is to click outside of the box. Now when I tap on Sally Student, I'm able to move it up and down. I can also, if this was a mistake, use the trash can icon to delete it, the edit button to go ahead and make a change, the copy button if I need to copy it, and if I'd like, I can also click on Speak This and it will read it to me. So because of the way we're doing this training, it's not talking, but that's okay. I need to do another text box to fill in. I am blank years old, so I'll go to that T again. Every time I want a new text box, I have to tap that T. I am, and we'll just say 13. Whoops. Again, I'm going to move it. Then my favorite color is, one more time, going to say pink. Now, just to point out, I can make my font bigger using the controls at the bottom. I can also change the font to any number of fonts that are available. Marker felt. I can also change the color. So if I want to make it red, that's fine with me too. I can change the opacity if necessary. And if I need a different color, more colors, you can find it here in this color wheel. Can also change the alignment as well. So here it's center justified, right justified, left justified. I'm done. All right, the next thing, I'm going to scroll up. It says, circle the shape with three corners. I'm going to go ahead and grab my pen, which is this one right here with the blue dot, and I'm going to circle the shape with three corners using my finger. If this line is too big or blue is not a good color, if I click on this blue right here, I can change the ink's color, I can change the opacity, how thick it is or how thin it is. And again, there's some color presets down below. If I made some stray marks because the pen stays engaged until I tap it and unhighlight it, I can use the eraser to erase the lines. The eraser works for the pen and the highlighter. So moving along, I'm gonna unchoose the highlighter. Now it says match uppercase to lowercase. At this point, you have a choice. You can use the pen or you can use the line tool. So we're gonna use the line tool just for fun. So if I tap on it, it will draw me a line with an arrow. And I can draw my lines. Again, same thing with that red dot. I can choose my line style. How should it start? How should it end? The colors, the thickness, and the opacity of it. To get rid of lines, the eraser will not work. I can use the undo button that's in the upper corner. Or I can tap on the line and then use the delete with the trash can. I'm just gonna go ahead and fill that out. Very good. And then I tap it again to unselect the lines. Moving on, the next thing it says is circle the number 5. I can use the pen for this, or because these numbers are really close together, I could use the highlighter. So I'm gonna just show you how the highlighter works. It's right there. Highlighter gives us a thicker line. So if I tap, it makes a nice little circle around the number 5. Again, if I take that yellow circle, it gives me the color, the opacity, how thick do I want it, all those options are right there. Just a reminder, the eraser does erase the highlighter. Same thing, it says color in half of the shape, so I can either choose to use my highlighter or my pen, and I think I'm going to use a highlighter, but I want it a little bit thinner. I can go ahead and color in half of that shape, showing that I understand fractions. Now I'm done. Now, we didn't look at all of the tools. We can also, with the picture icon, insert other pictures. So I can either use my camera to snap a picture, or I can use my photo library, which means that if I wanted to insert a picture of a Baltimore Oriole, I could go to Safari, save that picture to my photo library, and then import it here, or any other pictures that I've already previously taken. I can also add a sticky note. So if I need to write a lot of text in a small space, this might be a good thing to use. I can delete the note. However, for right now, I'm done. So I can go ahead and hit the X. And now I'm back to this home screen, home menu again. Since I'm done, I want to share it with my teacher so that way she can grade it. So I'm gonna use what we call the Sharrow. And it's that third box in the right menu. And you have a variety of options of where to share it. It depends on what additional apps you have available. You can add it to your notes or iBooks. Those are fairly standard. You can share it, you can copy it to Google Drive, you can share it via Classroom or Google Drive. It just really depends on what's available on your iPad. You can also add it to your iCloud Drive if this is your own iPad. You can open it, you can print it if you have access to a printer that will work with your iPad. You can also email it if you have an email account on here. However, I'm going to go ahead and use my Google Drive. So it should open up my Google Drive. You can see it has listed my file name, how big it is, what account I'm using. Do I want to put it in my drive? Do I want to put it in an additional folder? So you can choose where you want it to go. I'm going to let it go into my drive. You can also choose my sharing permissions. If I want to add people who can edit or who can just view it, I can go ahead and add them in via Google email. So I'm going to go ahead and click upload. That blue bar is going to finish. And it's been uploaded to my Google Drive. And now my teacher, when she opens Google Drive on her computer, can see exactly everything I've done. Just a note, not all of the annotations may show up on an iPad, but they will show up on a computer. If I'm done working with this one and I want to go and look and work on a different piece of work that I've been working on, if I go to my file folder, and go to my documents, and here is a list of all these other things, things I've been working on, so I can click on the one I want to see, which is my master peer review rubric, and then I need to click open. It will not automatically open. Now I can go ahead and work on this one. If I go to the gears, there are a few settings. I can change the background colors and speech settings, accounts. I can learn what version I'm using. It's very simple. I can also change the view and see what's going on if I have any annotations and bookmarks. So this is the basics of how to use ClaroPDF. Thanks for coming, and I hope you find this helpful. Have a great day.